Hi, this is Tanya Vos again, and in this video I'm going to talk about how to automate testing at the graphical user interface level. So in a previous video we've seen what is GUI testing. So basically it consists of specifying test sequences, sequences of graphical user interface actions like click, drag, drop, type, scroll, etc. and define a test oracle that indicates whether every state is correct or not. So basically, if we test Microsoft Word and a specific item of that, it's open Microsoft Word, click for example on the menu view, select the media browser and drag a picture into the Word file. So this can be a very typical small test sequences that we have to click each time manually. We've seen that if we want to do this manually, it's very tedious. It's tiresome and boring if we do have to do it all over and over again during regression testing. And when something is tedious, tiresome and boring, it's error prone. And moreover, it's very costly. So we detected already the need to automate testing at the graphical user interface. So the current state of the practice to automate graphical user interface testing is make scripts. We have defined test sequences, we have defined oracles, and then we develop script to automate these tests. We execute them and we maintain the script. So the state of the art is capture replay and visual testing. Capture replay tools, as the name already indicates, capture the user interaction and make scripts to replay that. So when a tester has a test sequence he wants to execute, he only once executes this manually by clicking through the test sequence, and then while doing it, the tool will record a script. And this script can then later on be replayed for automation. Examples of capture replay tools are open source Selenium or Abbott, and there's many more graphical user interface test tools that do capture replay. And the commercial side, there's for example QFTest, Rational Functional or Robot Tester, and there's many other capture replay tools, but just to give you a flavor of what is out there. The advantage of capture replay is that it's very simple. It's simple and easy. You just have to execute your test case manually once, you record a script that you can later on use to replay and automate your test. Disadvantages are actually that scripts break when your graphical user interface changes. And this causes a maintenance problem, because every time you have to do regression tests and your graphical user interface has changed, you have to repair the scripts to make them work again. And this is not a small problem. This maintenance problem is actually a huge problem, because graphical user interfaces change all the time and so do the requirements. So it turns out that capture replay scripts have this maintenance problem. In order to try to solve this maintenance problem, we have visual testing tools. So visual testing tools use image recognition in order to find areas where to click on. So now we don't have to indicate specific widgets, we can actually indicate places that look like an image that we have specified. Here's an example on the slide. It's to test an IKEA website with the Billy bookshelf. And here we see, for example, we go to the IKEA web, and here we click on something that looks like this picture. So we recognize the picture, we do the matching and see that we can somehow click here. Then we type Billy, push enter, and in the result we get, we want to click on this image, which is recognized by this bookshelf. Might somebody change the interface design of this website and move the Billy bookshelf somewhere else, this tool will still be able to find the place where to click on, because it recognizes the image. And then we check the price here, and we want to see that it coincides with $29.99. So this is also very easy to understand and simple to do. There's hardly any programming skills needed to make these type of scripts, and it solves part of the maintenance problem. However, it's not robust against all changes, because imagine, we were testing Microsoft Word and we wanted to go to the media browser. Imagine that somebody moves the media browser within the same menu, more up, for example. In that case, the tool script will not break, because it can still find the image. However, if we use the media browser and we move it to another menu that is not visible in a specific state, then obviously the script will also break. Or if we, for example, change the icon of the media browser, the script will break. So studies have shown that visual testing tools, although they solve part of the maintenance problem, still have this maintenance issue of the script. So what we propose in the Testomat project and in many projects before is the TestStar tool. TestStar actually does not have scripts, it's scriptless. And what is not there does not need to be maintained. And the other good thing about TestStar is that it starts from random testing. So we can immediately start test automation without any requirements. So how does that work? This is the TestStar loop that we execute to generate tests. We start up the system under test. We get the specific state where the GUI is in, so we get all the widgets and all their properties, and we check that state for any failures. If we have a failure, we have a test sequence leading to failure, and if not, and we still want to go on testing, we derive actions from the specific state of the user interface. From these actions, we select one, we execute that, and from the execution of an action, we go to a next state. This state, we can check again for failures. If we find a failure, we have a test sequence that leads to failure. And if not, we can go on and on by getting the state, checking the state, deriving actions, selecting actions, and executing these actions. So this is basically how the tool works. And we can do this very easily by setting in the TestStar dialog the path to the system under test that we want to test. Here, for example, we say that we want to test PowerPoint. We can set some specific actions that we do not want to execute, like, for example, close, exit, or minimize, or print. Those are actions that we don't want to execute during our test because they just stop the system or minimize it, which is not very interesting. And then we just test. Here we see an example where PowerPoint is tested automatically with random action selection, and you see it clicks on all the actions, and in the end we find a crash. So for what applications does it work? Because I said you can start testing immediately. Well, actually we use the accessibility API at the operating system level to obtain the state of the graphical user interface. So since this is at the operating system level, we can basically test all applications this way when they respect the accessibility API of the underlying operating system. So it looks a little bit like this, the architecture of TestStar. There is an abstraction layer into which you can plug in a specific component for a specific operating system. So if we test PowerPoint, obviously we have to plug in for Windows, but we can think of plugins for macOS, Android, or anything you need. And the good thing here is also, since browsers that run web applications are specifically systems that run on an operating system, they also will recognize the state of the graphical user interface of the web application. So we can start automated testing immediately with a minimal setup. There's no scripts, and here there's no maintenance because the widget tree is extracted in every new state. So if the state is different, so is the widget tree. So the action selection is actually based on the current state you're in. So now you can ask yourself, okay, so you actually select each action at random at every step. What are you actually testing then? Well, this is going to be a topic for a next video on the TestStar tool within the Testomat project.